I now own this company, Camping Cruisers. The company's been running now for 21 years. Started off with just one canal boat, and now we've got eight. And the one we're on now is the youngest, which is going to be ready in 2 weeks' time. A lot of people we get are people who want to get away from the cities. They want a slower pace of life for that 1 week or short break. And we also get the diehards, where the people who just literally every holiday go off canal boating. They love canal boating so much, they'll literally go from one canal to another canal to another canal. The canal's 33 miles long, the main of it is. And it does take a week to do it. You can't, by boat, it takes a week, because you only do about 2 miles an hour.
Should be in the Guinness Book of Records as the world's worst guard dog. Her great ambition in life would be to have a burglar so she can hold the lamp for him. I'm John French. I'm basically English, although I have a Welsh grandmother. We came to live here after I'd spent most of my working life abroad because my wife and I wanted to come back to this country. And we looked around for somewhere that was a little less crowded than most of England. And I tried to go back to my old home. It was mostly concrete. So we looked around, and this looked like England used to look 50 or 60 years ago. So we're here. I think we've got to say it must have been built in connection with the canal. It can't be here, facing where it is just by chance. And if you look at the front of it, you can see that it must have been built as two cottages. There are two doors, there's two sets of windows, which are exactly the same. And I would make a guess that maybe the commercial manager for the canal lived in one and the engineering manager lived in the other. One to make sure they got the money and one to keep it working. They're a bit too nice for the labourers, so I think it must have been management. Everybody in the village refers to it as the old workhouse. In fact, the bridge over the canal here is in the guidebooks as the workhouse bridge. So we said, well, we better call it the old workhouse. It opened for business on Christmas Eve 1799, which always seems to me a little strange, the day when most people would have taken off, I would have thought, but that was it. Unfortunately, I doubt it made anybody very much money because the railways came along within less than 50 years afterwards, and so the enormous effort that went into putting a canal like this up the side of a Welsh hill probably wasn't recovered, but it was very busy for a good many years. It's purely leisure now, but they keep it looking nice, and it's said to be one of the most beautiful canals in the British Isles. And in fact, it does pass through some lovely areas. Thank you.
This canal is used a lot. It's the prettiest canal in Britain. Boaters, cyclists, walkers, dog walkers, everybody. And all day as well. It's not just like a sunny afternoon job. People are up and down here all day long. We used to walk it, but on a Sunday, my father used to pick us up from chapel in the afternoon and take us for a walk. His idea of a walk was at least 15 miles, and we wouldn't get back until the night time. But my mother worked and she had a shop, so on a Sunday afternoon, she would bake for the week. So to get us out of the way, he'd take us for a walk, see? My two brothers and myself, and we'd walk forever. And so I'm quite DNA coded for this area. Although I'm up in the valleys, my father's family are all from down here.
I'm Luke Webb. I'm 20. I'm from Cumbrian. I'm fishing. So all the rubbish gets blown in as well. People dropping it everywhere and just gets blown in the water. They do clean it out, but as soon as they clean it out, it's just back in there again. Some big fishing, you know.
Yeah.
Carp, pike. All the normal little fish as well. Bream, roach, perch, goldfish, tench, all sorts of stuff in here. I've seen a couple of people swimming in here, but not a lot else. A couple of dogs. You know that big pike that's in here? He got it yesterday, he upped it a bit through his line now. Using maggot he has. Not bad. I've been fishing for about 6 years on the canals, and year by year, I think it's getting worse, I do. There's pollution in there, the water's getting dirtier, don't catch as many fish, all the rubbish in there, all the stingies on the sides and all, they're not cut back or nothing like that.
It used to be, didn't it?
Yeah, it used to be spick and span around here. We was fishing by here on this bank, and he upped into a fish. We got it into the side down by there, and I walked down to grab it, and I went to grab it, and there was like all warts on it. It looked like diseases and all.
Had some sort of problem anyway.
Just cut the line and put it back in, we did.
Yeah.
who aren't touching it.
My name's Roger, I'm 79 now, and I've lived in and around Newport all my life, and worked there as well. As a place to live, it's far, far nicer than a lot of people think. People think South Wales is all coal tips and steelworks and collieries and God knows what, but it's not the case. I remember a cousin of mine from Canada. He was drafted into the Canadian Air Force and came over here, and he came to see us on one occasion. I remember walking from the bottom of the 14 locks up to here and then back round on the main road to get home. And that would be around about 1943, 44, I suppose. But of course, there was nothing happening here at all, really. I mean, it was just a backwater, a literal backwater. And that's how it's always been. I mean, it's great for people walking the dogs, and if you want walking a girlfriend for that member, I remember doing that somewhat later. that'd be about 1950. But I was 9 when the war began and 15 when it ended. So in those years, we played here, but I remember coming along with a toboggan full of snowballs on one occasion, which it must have been quite heavy snow, must have had, as we were looking for another lot of fellas to throw them at, but no, not much. And that's it, gentle decline. That's the sad thing, really, about the canals. And nobody started to do anything about it until they got, into disrepair, which is a shame.